Okay, in this video I want to talk about just some basic arithmetic, and multiplying decimals is what we're going to do here. So I've got three examples here I'm going to do them in order here. There's really nothing too tricky about this. There's just one little thing you got to remember, and then after that it's just being, I think, you know, it's just knowing your multiplication tables. So in the first example, we'll take 1.65 times 7. You don't have to. My own personal preference is, notice the first number has 3 digits and the second number has 1. I like to put the number with more digits on top. Again, you don't have to. It's just a matter of my personal preference. And then I'm going to multiply this by the number 7. When I do this, I'm not worried about lining up decimals or anything like that. At this point, I'm really not even concerned that there's a decimal actually in the problem. Okay, so 7 times 5, that's 35, so we'll drop down the 5, carry the 3. 7 times 6 is 42. 42 plus 3, again, will give us 45, so we'll drop down the 5. We'll have to carry the 4. And then 7 times 1 is 7. Plus 4 will give us 11. So right now I have the number 1155, which is clearly not correct. All you have to do, though, notice there's only one number that really has a decimal place that's visible, and that's the 1.65. And notice if you kind of count, if you were to move it to the right to where the last digit is, you'd have to move the decimal places 2 places. Okay, so notice the decimal place is 2 places from the end of the number. And what you do is you simply take your final answer and you count over that many decimal places as well. So we had to go 2 decimal places to the left. So on my final answer, I'll move the decimal place over 2 places, and that will give me my final answer of 11.55. So let's do another one here, hopefully make this make a little more sense. Okay, so now we've got the number 2.34, and again I'm going to multiply that by the number 1.2. Again, I'm really not concerned at all with the decimals, I'm just treating these like whole numbers at the moment. So 2 times 4 is 8, 2 times 3 is 6, 2 times 2 is 4. Okay, and now I'll move on to my next number. So 1 times 4 is 4. 1 times 3 is 3. 1 times 2 is 2. So now I just add these up. So 8, and sometimes people will put a 0. When I was a kid, they always told us to put an X. So that's just my own old habit. So you can put a 0 or whatever. And we add. So 8 plus 0 is 8. 6 and 4 is 10. So we'll drop down the 0. Carry the 1. 1 plus 4 is 5, plus 3 is 8. Drop the 2 right down. So right now we have the number 2808. And again, we just do the same thing. Notice in the first number, if our decimal place was to be at the end, we would have to move it 2 times, or let's say 2 places. Notice if my decimal place had been on the right of the bottom number, I would have to move it over 1 place. What you do is you add up the total number of places that the decimals moved over. So you had to move it 1, 2, 3 times total. So that's what we'll do on the bottom number. We'll move the decimal over 1, 2, 3 times, and that will give us our final answer. So 2.34 times 1.2 is the number 2.808. Okay, so let's do one last one here. So suppose I have the number, suppose we got to multiply, so I think this one will be a little longer. So 21.95, we'll have to multiply this by 1.867. And again, notice, before I even multiply, again, at the very beginning, if you look at 21.95, if the decimal place was all the way to the right, we would have to move it 1, 2 places. If I look at the number that I'm multiplying by on the bottom, if we put the decimal place all the way to the right, to get it in its proper place, I would have to move it 1, one, two, three places. So that means my final answer, the decimal, will have to be moved a total of five places. Okay, so have to remember this and keep this in mind. But again, other than that, it's just going to be a matter of, you know, just multiplying, pretending they're whole numbers, and just putting the decimal place where it needs to be. All right, so let's see if we can't, let me make this a little prettier. So let's see if we can't do this. So 21.95 times 1.867. So a little tedious here. Okay, so 7 times 5 is 35, so we'll drop down the 5, carry the 3. 7 times 9 is 63 plus 3 is 66, so we'll drop down the 6, carry a 6. 7 times 1 is 7 plus 6 is 13, so we'll drop down the 3, carry the 1. 7 times 2 is 14, add 1, that'll give us 15. All right, so now we've kind of taken care of the 7. So let's see, 6 times 5 is 30, so we'll drop down the 0, carry the 3. 6 times 9 is 54, plus 3 is 57, we'll carry the 5. 6 times 1 is 6, plus 5 is 11, carry the 1. 6 times 2 is 12, plus 1 is 13. Okay, so now I've taken care of the 6. Now I have to put two placeholders. So 8 times 5 is 40, so we'll drop down the 0, we'll carry the 4. 8 times 9 is 72, plus 4 is 76, we'll carry the 7. 8 times 1 is 8, plus 7 is 15, again we'll carry the 1. 8 times 2 is 16, 16 plus 1 is 17. Okay, so we're almost there, very tedious. At least the last number will be easy. So we're just multiplying everything by 1, so we'll simply get 5, 9, 1, 2. And now we just have to add all these numbers together, and at the end just move the decimal place over the correct number of times. So in the first column, again, my x's are zeros. So we'll get 5, we'll get 6 plus 0, which is 6. We'll get 3 plus 7, which is 10, so we'll drop down the 0, carry the 1. 1 and 5 is 6, plus 1 is 7, plus 6 is 13, plus 5 is 18. Again, we'll have to carry a 1. 1 and 1 is 2, plus 3 is 5, plus 5 is 10, plus 9 is 19. Carry the 1. 1 and 1 is 2, plus 7 is 9, plus 1 is 10. We'll drop down the 0, and we'll carry the 1. So 1 and 1 and 2 is 4. Whew. Very tedious here. Okay, so... So now, again, all we have to do is, again, back to what we did at the beginning, we counted, so I had to move the decimal place over 1, 2 in the first one, 1, 2, 3 in the second one. So again, we said we had to move it a total of 5 places, so if it starts on the end, it would move over 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it says the decimal place should go right there. So it says 21.95 times 1.867 is going to be equal to 40.98065. One thing I would definitely recommend, you know, just to make sure that you do have the decimal place and the correct place, you know, if we rounded this off, you know, if we took our numbers, 21.95, that's roughly equal to 22 if we round it up. 1.867, that's roughly equal to 2, so if we multiplied 2 and 22, we would get 44. But again, 22 is bigger than the number that I'm using. 2 is also bigger than the number that I'm using, so I know this estimate of 44 should be a touch bigger than the correct answer. And, well, 44 is a little bit bigger than 40.98065, so that seems like a reasonable answer. So all I'm saying is you can use estimation at the end real quickly. You know, if I had had the decimal place where it was 4.09, well, that can't be right. Likewise, if I had the decimal place, you know, at 409, 409, again, you know, just as a quick estimate, I know that can't be correct. Something would be wrong. Okay, so I hope this video makes some sense. I'm going to do some others as well where you have to divide numbers involving decimals, so feel free to take a look at that as well.